You may be seated. We'll just take a moment to welcome Sadie as she comes forward. Our first speaker today that we're very excited for. Thank you. Thank you, George. Sadie is the mother of two wonderful boys. Kate, who is a fourth grader, who just received his first communion last Sunday here at Grace Lutheran, so it was a wonderful celebration. And then Mason, who is a second.
First grader.
Well, I don't mean to push him along through school. So welcome, Sadie.
Thank you. Good morning and happy Mother's Day to all of you. As my oldest son, Cade, said to me last night, "Mom, Mother's Day is your day. Dad, Father's Day is your day. And the rest of the days are the kids' days." So to all moms, please take time to enjoy your one special day this year. After declining to speak on Mother's Day for the past couple years, I finally caved. Pastor Kendall and Jesse can be quite persistent when they want to be. So when I texted Pastor Kendall and asked him what I should talk about, his response was simple: just get up and cry a lot. I asked for a bit more help. So he followed with something more concrete. Speak about parenting and raising your own children in faith and why that's important to you. Or how your own faith strengthens or influences you as a mom. Okay, that was something I could work with. So I sat down late last night, procrastinating just like I tell my students not to, and began to think about my faith and the role it has in being a mom. I kept going back to three important women in my life who have demonstrated to me what being a mom of faith means. Each one of these women has taught me lessons I try and model for my own kids. So that is what I'd like to share today. Three special moms who shaped my faith growing up and how that influences me as a mom. First, I thought about my grandma Presto. She was one of the strongest women of faith I have ever known. When I was younger, I would often see the Bible on the table, by her chair, or on the dining room table. She could frequently be found reading God's Word. As a mom, that is something I want my children to see me doing. Reading the Bible, doing a daily devotion, talking with them about their Sunday school lessons, teaching them to use God's Word to guide their lives. She also taught me, through watching her lose her own son, that while life isn't always fair, and that we'll have to face trials, God is there to comfort us and to guide us through loss, grief, and hardships. Because of this lesson she taught me, I have been able to teach my own boys that. They have witnessed me losing two grandparents in the past 2 years, struggling through the tragic loss of a student, and this past year, losing two former co-workers who were also close friends. As a mom of faith, I have been able to teach my kids that even though losing someone is hard, we have an assurance that we'll see them again in heaven. And I thank my grandma Crystal and her strong faith for teaching me that. Another woman who has influenced my faith as a mom is my grandma Dora. Even though she wasn't very vocal about her faith, her actions modeled what a godly servant is. She lived her life always putting others before herself. Her children, her parents, and family members' needs always came before her own. And she never did something expecting something in return. I believe that's how Jesus lived too. He gave of himself, humbled himself, and served others. He gave his life for ours. Her legacy of faith to me is that she gave of herself and always put others first. And that's something I want to teach my boys as well. And of course, the last person I have learned about being a woman of faith from is my own mom. Much like my grandma Jordan, my mom has always had a servant's heart. She has taught me that we do things for others, not to get something in return. We help others because that's what Jesus would want us to do. We do what we can, we help how we can, and we give what we can. It doesn't matter who someone is or where they came from. We are all his children. She lives by the verse of Matthew 25 that says, "Whatever you do to the least of my brothers, you do to me." She taught me that we are all equal in God's eyes, all deserving of his love. That's one lesson I pray I can instill in my children as well. So hopefully the lessons I learned from these three women of faith will be lessons I can pass down to Cade and Mason. I want to teach them to seek answers and guidance in God's Word, like my grandma Crystal, and that no matter what we face in life, there is eternal life waiting for us. I also want to teach my boys to have servant-minded hearts, like their grandma Jordan, and that being humble and sacrificing for others isn't a sign of weakness. Rather, it is a life that resembles Jesus' life. all, we are all His children, unique and wonderful. And we should look through God's eyes when we look at others, see them as He does, like my mom taught me. So despite trying to ignore and avoid Pastor Kendall's prodding to share with you today about what a mom of faith means to me, I am grateful for this opportunity to share a bit about how my faith has been influenced by three great moms. And I consider myself very fortunate to not only have these three great women influence my life, but many other women as well. The greatest gift we can give our children, I believe, is a life rooted in faith. Psalm 100, verse 5 says, "For the Lord is good, His unfailing love continues forever, and His faithfulness continues to each generation." And I pray that the faith shared with me by my grandmas and mom will not end with me, but will continue to the next faithful generation. Happy Mother's Day.
And each new role is a new joy. And they get very excited if grandma is coming, great grandma, because they say, cinnamon bread? So if you get known for something special, we gotta hang on to that. And a cat. So you have a few things that they really love about you. And so you see the love of God when I look in their little faces. And my precious great-grandchildren, the joy gets bigger and greater as they grow. And our prayer lists get really, really long. I do like a prayer that I want them to remember and that I want to remember. Always pray to have eyes that see the best in people, a heart that forgives the worst, a mind that forgives the bad, and a soul that never loses faith in God. So today, as we go, and God has given us this beautiful day to enjoy, and He's also given us mothers. So let us give thanks to God for all the mothers in our lives. And there are many kinds, many ways that people are a mother. So we will take time to give thanks and praise to your mom. And a few hugs. Thank you.
Diane Pete is our next mother to speak. Diane was blessed with two children through adoption to become a loving mother. Are you going to talk about your kids, or shall I talk about them? Okay. All right, thank you, Diane.
Well, I want to begin by acknowledging all mothers out there for their role in raising children and maintaining a family. I've always felt that parenting is one of the most important tasks that one can accomplish in your life, but one for which there's very little training. I would call it on-the-job training. So we rely on faith, example, and just doing our best in each situation that presents itself. What was different for me than most of you was how I became a mother. We always wanted to have children, but it didn't happen naturally. During that period of time, I experienced disappointment and frustration in not becoming pregnant. I sought some medical intervention, but it did not make a difference. Although I was very happy for friends and family who had children, I thought, why can't this be us enjoying the excitement of becoming pregnant, experiencing the joy of giving birth, and bringing a new life into the world? Our prayers were not answered in the way that we were hoping. The road that led us to think about adoption was paved for us by our friends, Sam and Mary Olson. They had adopted two girls, Sarah and Martha. At the time, we checked with Lutheran Social Service about adopting a Caucasian child, but the wait was so long. Sam and Mary had worked with Children's Home Society in St. Paul, where they had a positive experience. So we started the process through that agency. We were assigned a caseworker, and we met with her individually, as well as in small group sessions with other potential parents wishing to adopt. It was our choice to request a Korean baby girl. We received a picture of her, and the wait for her arrival began. God answered our prayers with the delivery of a five-month-old, He Sook Kim, via airplane on May 26th, 1982. Just days after her arrival was my brother's high school graduation, where we proudly introduced her to our family. We did not worry too much about bringing a Korean child into our family or our community. There were other families in Dawson, along with Olsons, who have made it easy for us since they already adopted Korean children into their families. There have never been any issues because of their heritage being different than the rest of us. We wanted Laura to have a brother. So 2 years later, six-month-old Jung Man Yoo arrived via airplane on June 22, 1984. I remember the first time we brought David to church. After he arrived, it was right through that door. There were the ladies standing, and I was just exploding with joy to show off this little boy with hair that stuck straight up. There is a saying in the adoption world, you did not grow under my heart, so much pride in having these two precious children that created a family for Woody and I. Even though the way I became a mother was through adoption, I did not view myself any different than any other mother. We experienced the same challenges as all parents do. And as I said at the beginning, you do your best. But I also feel that it takes a village to raise a child. And we live in a wonderful village where David and Laura received a good education in school and were nurtured in our church family by caring people who influenced them as they grew up. We will always be grateful to our church family who showed care and concern, not only for them, but for all young people. I often tell people that we kind of forget that Laura and David are Korean or that they look different since they grew up in our culture, our heritage, and our faith. David says that he feels uncomfortable around other Asian people because he's only Asian on the outside, but skinny people on the inside. When Laura was pregnant with Emily, we were kicking around about the possibility of her having twins. I said, I doubt that will happen. There are no twins in our extended family. And she looked at me and she said, Mother, do you realize what you just said? I am so blessed to be their mother, and now a grandmother to Aiden and Emily. Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you all so much for sharing with us. I got a little teary-eyed up here, so that was beautiful. Thank you so much. Now we will move into our hymn of the day, but before we do that, are there any children in here that would be willing to help hand out some gifts? I see a few. We have some Mother's Day gifts to give all the women to celebrate mothers and women and to celebrate this beautiful day. So, oh, I see a whole bunch now. Great. So if you want to go over to Pastor Kendall, you can grab some of the gifts. And as we sing, the children will come and deliver a gift to you. So our hymn of the day is Blessed Be the Tie That Binds, hymn number 656. missing anybody? Okay, good. I'd like to invite you, if you were able, to stand for the litany for Mother's Day. Mothers come in many different forms, and today we celebrate them all. Everyone here is either a son or a daughter. For those women who have joined God in heaven and whom we miss dearly here on earth. For every woman who is working day and night to raise her children right now. For all the women who are expecting, but aren't quite mothers yet.
Thank God for the soon to be mothers.
For the women who took in others' children through adoption and foster care.
Thank God for the mothers who are so faithful.
For those women who have lost a child to death and must carry on. But chose instead to mother everyone else.
Thank God for mothers in spirit. We thank you, Lord, for all women who have influenced our lives in so many ways. We pray that you will honor them in everything we do. Amen.
Together, let us confess our Christian faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our prayers today are going to look a little different. I'm going to be reading through and lighting a candle for each petition, so there will be no need to respond with, "Hear our prayer." At the end, I'll invite you all to just close with Amen with me. Today we pray for those who are like Tamar, struggling with infertility or a miscarriage. We pray for those who are like Rachel, counting the women among their family and friends year by year and month by month get pregnant while they wait. We pray for the women who are like Naomi and have known the bitter sting of a child's death. We pray for anyone who is like Joseph and Benjamin, and your mother has passed from this world on to the next. May you feel God's peace and presence fall upon you today. We pray for anyone who is like Moses' mother and put a child up for adoption, trusting another family to love their child into adulthood. We pray for the women who are like Pharaoh's daughter, called to love children who are not theirs by birth. We pray for many who who are watching or have watched their mother age and disappear to the long goodbye of dementia or Alzheimer's. We pray for the women who are like Mary, are pregnant for the very first time and waiting anxiously for the miracle of their first child. We pray for the mothers who had children turn away from them, painfully closing the door on relationship, leaving them holding broken hearts. And like Hagar, now they feel alone. We pray for the women who, like so many women before them, do not wish to be a mother, are not married, or in so many other ways do not feel like they fit into societal norms. May they know their value this day and every day. And we pray for everyone and anyone who is reflected in all or none of these stories. This Mother's Day, wherever and whoever you are, we pray with you. You are loved, you are seen, and you are worthy. And may you know the deep love that is without end of our beautiful God, who is the very best example of a parent that we know, who gave his one and only Son that we may have eternal life. And in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.